you know, we have this movie image and it's not too far away from it.
Daryl Holton of Shelbyville, Tennessee, chose the electric chair for his 2007 execution 10 years earlier. He shot to death three of his own children and their half-sister. Holton said he did not want to lose them in a custody battle. When Holton was executed, it was the first time the electric chair had been used in Tennessee since 1960. A member of the New York Times and this reporter were among the witnesses for the 1 a.m. execution. I was asked to describe the moment when voltage shot through Holton while strapped to the chair.
The jolt of electricity was, I mean, to watch the body, just it went up very suddenly, maybe 4 to 6 inches, and it would go for, he would stay up that entire time while the voltage was coming through the body for 20 seconds, and then he slumped like this.
That electric chair is now how Edmund Zagorski has chosen to die for the 1993 murders of two men who were trying to buy marijuana from him. But one of his attorneys 4 years ago argued the method of execution is unconstitutional.
When the electric chair does what it's supposed to do, it literally cooks the internal organs.
In a statement late Monday from Henry, she said, faced with the choice of two unconstitutional methods of execution, Mr. Zagorski has indicated that if his execution is to move forward, he believes that the electric chair is the lesser of two evils. 10 to 18 minutes of drowning, suffocation, and chemical burning is unspeakable. By law, Zagorski can choose the electric chair because he was sentenced to death before 1999. Reporting from the state capitol, Chris Bungard.